Hi, it's Will from StolenCastle.com, and here in YouTube, you know me as Epic Fantasy. And this is a tutorial on how to make ink fast and easy. Dioramas, origami, catapults, and treasure chests, telescopes, terrariums, bonsai trees, and paper games, swords and shields, and real blacksmithing, model blocks, and animation. I teach the art of real creation. StolenCastle.com. Let's make something. In previous tutorials, I showed you how to make paper. And I showed you how to make a quill so you could write on the paper. So now in this tutorial, we're going to make the ink and put it all together, finish it all up. And now you have everything. So this is, we're going to make an ink out of berries. You can use either blackberries, raspberries, blueberries. You need a strainer and a bowl, some salt, some water, and some vinegar, and a little container, some kind of little bottle or jar to put your ink in. You can also, to smush up the berries, you can also use a mortar and pestle. You know, and you'll see how to do that. And there's our quill to write with. So let's do it. Typically, in a recipe like this, you're going to use about a half a cup of berries. And I'm going to use the blackberries here because that actually makes a pretty good ink. I like the color of the ink. And you just mush them up any way you can because you want just the juice. See the juice coming out in the bottom there? I'll show you a little bit more here. And you don't need a whole lot. Ink goes a long ways, you know that, right? But do your half a cup of berries until you get enough juice. And oh, you see how I used a crumpled foil ball there? That's actually kind of nice. I crumpled up some aluminum foil and used that to do more mushing. Is that a real word, mushing? Then you add about a half a teaspoon of plain old white vinegar to it. And I kind of, this is really loose. You can kind of tinker with it. See, I spilled some there and I figured, it's about a half a teaspoon. Looks pretty good. You can always tinker with it and add a little bit, maybe add some more juice to get the ink the consistency you want. And then about a half a teaspoon, the vinegar, makes the ink, the berry, attach to the paper, adhere to the paper well, and then you add a half a teaspoon of salt, and what that does is it's a preservative. It prevents the ink from going bad because it is a berry. And this is optional, but to thin out your ink if it needs it, you can always add a little bit of water or a little bit more vinegar. There we go. That's it. You've made ink. Stir it up really good, and you're done. And I tried different berries. See, the blueberry, blackberry, you know, so it's kind of fun. Raspberry, kind of nice. The different types of berries you can experiment to make your ink for your quill. That's it. Make some ink. If you make this project, make sure you write something out and send me a picture. Be fun. I'd like to see it. Put it in your little container and you're ready to go. It's fast and easy tutorial, a lot shorter than my normal tutorials, and I probably appreciate that, but I like it. Thanks for watching my video. Thanks for subscribing. If you're a subscriber, if you're not a subscriber, hit that button. Always fun and interesting projects. Here you go. Those other tutorials that I mentioned up top, you can click on that if you want to see how to make paper. Down below, you can click on that if you want to see how to make a feather quill pen. Thank you. Oh, I also have a tutorial on how to make a scroll, a medieval scroll. That's a fun tutorial.